We also recommend very strongly that you use this feature to pre-post any questions you might have. I promise you, I'm taking notes of all the questions that show up in the chat window, and I will place them for our presenter today, as and when they open up the Zoom webinar for questions and answers. So definitely encourage you to connect with other individuals on chat, maybe other educators who you think are doing interesting work, or other like-minded individuals you'd like to connect with. Please use the chat window to do so. Additionally, also post all questions you might have. Once you click on the participants button at the bottom, you will be able to also see the feature called raise hand, yes, no, or go slower. When you click on those, I will know that you have a question or you want to say something or you'd like to like for our speaker to go slower or faster as required, and I will be able to address you personally. So kindly request you to use that feature as well. I think I saw our speaker for today join us. Deepali, have you joined us? Are you here?
Yes, that's right. I'm here. Hello, everyone.
Hello. Good evening, Deepali.
Hi. Good evening. So we're starting at 5:30, right? We've got a few minutes to go.
Yes, yes. This is a pre-webinar presentation. We're just going over some features of Zoom. And we're asking our participants to do a little bit of introduction of themselves today in the chat box. So they're sharing with us their names, where they're coming from, where they are currently in this lockdown, as well as why they're here today, what brings them to our webinar today. So Deepali, if we could ask you as well to share, just give us a very brief introduction, your name, where you're doing this webinar from. That would be really, really great. Just to like, and how you're feeling during this lockdown, just a good way to start us off as well.
Sure. Rahul, do you want me to say it or do you want me to type it in the chat?
No, I would love for you to say it out loud.
Okay. Hi, everyone. It's lovely to be here and thank you for joining. I can see a lot of familiar names on the screen. So hello to you. I'm here in Pune. We live in the midst of unprecedented times. So our city is in complete lockdown. So it's pretty scary, but I'm doing okay. And thankfully, my family is too. I hope you all are well also.
Thank you very much, Deepali. Just a couple of quick tips, guys. Given the large number of people we are expecting to join us on call today, we request you all to kindly place yourselves on mute for the duration of this webinar. Only if Deepali asks you to speak, kindly take yourself off mute. This is to prevent any echoes from coming across. Additionally, to save some bandwidth, we request you to please place your videos off throughout this webinar.
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Yes.
Yeah, this is Subhashini here.
Hi, Subhashini. Thank you for joining us. We're going to begin very soon. Request you to kindly place yourself on mute. So a quick, really, really brief introduction. The working of the world has changed in the past 2 months, and so has the way we learn. In this unprecedented times, when everything has come to a halt, FIRKI is continuously moving with the purpose to keep our teaching and learning processes going through a specially designed initiative, Learning During Lockdown. This initiative contains a plethora of virtual sessions and resources across a wide range of topics, categorized broadly under 3 buckets: work from home, getting ready for school, and health and wellness. So please keep looking for communication about each of these webinars in your inboxes in the coming days. FIRKI recently launched its Teachers of India campaign. Teachers of India is an initiative to recognize the contributions of the teaching community towards building a nation of capable learners and leaders. If you are a teacher, we want to celebrate you. Please send in your story in the link visible on your screens. It will shortly be shared on the chat window as well. I am sharing this link in your window as well. We want to celebrate you, dear teachers. So request you to share in your stories with us on the link that is present in your chat window right now. Once again, a quick reminder, we are going to begin the webinar at 5:25. This is a pre-webinar presentation. During this time, we request you to kindly place yourselves on mute to prevent any echoes from going across, and also kindly place your videos off to save some bandwidth. Thank you very much. I see a number of individuals who are sharing a little bit about themselves in the chat window. Nupur from Jubilee Hills Public School in Hyderabad. Welcome, Nupur. Mandeep from Chandigarh, welcome as well. A number of individuals. I see someone. We've got a number of people. I'm not going to read everyone's names, but it's great to have you here, everybody. Thank you very much for joining us. We're going to get started shortly.
ज्वाइन करने से मुझे अपने अंदर काफी कॉन्फिडेंस भी आया और बच्चों के अंदर क्या इम्प्रूवमेंट कर सकती हूँ इसका भी मुझे फायदा मिला है. हमेशा कुछ नया सीखने की कोशिश में रहती हूँ ताकि बच्चों को भी कुछ कराते वक्त जहाँ कहीं भी परेशानी है उसके लिए कोई सलूशन हो. तो फिरकी मेरे ख्याल से हमें कुछ सलूशन देने के लिए है और फिरकी अपने नाम से ही जाहिर है कि फिरकी मतलब वो चीज़ जो चारों तरफ घूमती हो यानी कि एक चौतरफा जिसका असर हो और शायद वो चतुर्मुखी विकास में बच्चों के लिए मदद करे. तो मुझे अच्छा लगा इस कार्यक्रम में आके. फिरकी ज्वाइन करके मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा बच्चों के बारे में कुछ सीखने को अपनी गलतियां सुधारने को उसको देखने के बाद अब बच्चों की गलतियां सुधारने का मौका मिला जिससे हमें बच्चों में पता लग सके हम कि क्या क्या चेंज करके बच्चों में क्या इम्प्रूवमेंट कैसे कर सकते हैं क्या इम्प्रूवमेंट हम अपने आप में कर सकते हैं जिससे बच्चों में पढ़ने का इंटरेस्ट आए.
कुछ नई चीज़ें सुनने के लिए नए ढंग से मिली हैं और मैं चाहूँगी कि इन नई चीज़ों को नए तरीके से कुछ अपनी सोच के साथ मैं बच्चों पर ही में इस्तेमाल कर सकूं ताकि वो बच्चों के लिए भी उपयोगी हो और मेरे भी अनुभव में वृद्धि करें आगे बढ़ने में मदद करें. क्योंकि हमारा जो काम है वो ऐसा है जिसमें हम हमेशा सीखते रहते हैं और सिखाते रहते हैं. तो शायद फिरकी इसके लिए एक बहुत ही अच्छा माध्यम है. मैं बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ सर. थैंक यू फिरकी.
Thank you very much, Ellie. For all of you who are joining in just now, we see a number of people who've just joined in. Welcome to the webinar today. Today's webinar is on technology for teachers, which is a need of the hour, where it's in partnership with British Council. We already have our speaker for today, Deepali Dharmaraj, who's already on the call. Feel free to ask her any questions or to interact with her in the chat window. We'll get started in precisely 4 minutes or so. And before this, I would love to just take us through a couple of really quick norms. Given that we're expecting a large number of people to join us today on Zoom, I would request you to please place yourselves on mute. This will ensure that there is no cross connection or no echoes on the call. Additionally, would request you to please place your videos off. This will ensure that we're saving bandwidth throughout this call. Yeah. Thank you so much, guys. I can see a number of, and if you've just joined us, would love for you guys to please use the chat window and share a little bit with us about your name, where you're joining us from, where are you locked down currently, as well as what brings you to the webinar today. I can see a few introductions here. Shalini Bhatnagar from Delhi, Anuradha Modi from, not sure where that is, Rohini? Rita Bakshi from Delhi as well. Welcome, guys. Welcome a large number of you here today. Uma from Chennai as well. Thank you so much for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you on our call. We'll get started in the next 2 or 3 minutes.
Can you hear me clearly, Rahul? Because I don't have my headphones or a mic or anything on. Just depending
on the pattern. Yes, we can hear. Guys, would really appreciate it if you could put it in the chat window if you can hear. Deepali, if you can just introduce yourself really quickly and again, where you're locked down just really quickly, and then we'll get started. Deepali, can you hear me?
I can, yes.
Yes, okay. Can everybody else hear Deepali? Is that clear? Just give us a yes in the chat window. Yes, I can. Yes, Swapna says can hear. Mandeep
okay,
says okay.
Thank you.
Okay, that's good. Okay, so that works. All right. I think we're ready to get started in another minute or so. Okay. Give us another minute and then we'll get started. Just waiting for a few more people to join us. We have a number of people waiting to join in. So we're just going to admit as many people as possible into the room and then we get started. Deepali, I hope you're ready.
I'm ready and I'll share the presentation from my laptop. Huh?
In a little while, yes. But in a little while, I'll let you know when we are ready to get started. Yeah. Okay. I think we can get started now. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Firki's webinar on technology for teachers, need of the hour, in partnership with the British Council. My name is Rahul Gomes. I'm a course designer on the Firki team, and I'll help you navigate through this webinar today. We will begin by watching a short video that will help you introduce you to Firki, the website, and its feature. Ellie, if you could get us started.
Offers a diverse set of content for teachers to support them in their professional development as well as in their classrooms, and is free of charge and easy to use. In order to access the portal, type firki.co and you will be directed to the Firki website. To register on Firki, fill in a brief registration form. You can also sign in through your Google account. You will have to use your email ID in order to create an account on our website. This account is again free to create and use. Once you create your account and log in with your credentials, you will be directed to the dashboard. The dashboard would have notifications related to your profile, course progress, time spent, and your Firki discussion tab. To access certification courses, you can click on the courses link on the top left of the screen. The courses page allows you to choose courses based on difficulty level and category. The courses are also available in different regional languages. Feel free to browse the different courses we have in our catalog using the search bar above. Each Firki course is designed using the FITS model that stands for Feel, Imagine, Do, and Share. The Feel section of the course helps you identify your current practices. The Imagine section defines the practices that one should follow to improve teaching and learning outcomes. A detailed description of strategies are highlighted under the Do section that one can implement in the classroom and with their students. At last, the Share section talks about ways in which one can share their learnings with each other. Each course has also a set of reflection questions as part of the assessment section. Along with the course material, each Firki course also contains a learning circle plan and journal pages. A learning circle plan helps the coaches and mentors conducting the offline learning circles to discuss and share learnings from the course. A journal page summarizes the course with important points. We are adding new courses every month, so keep watching this page. Next up, we have the webinars page that is also accessible from the top left of the screen. On this page, you will find information about the upcoming webinars. If you scroll down, you will find a bunch of resources from our older webinars. These resources will include video recordings of the webinar itself, notes from the webinar, the presentation used by our speaker, and other resources on the topic covered. Do feel free to browse this section at your leisure. The final page to look out for is the resources page, also to be found at the top left corner of your screen. This page houses and will house resources from several of our partner organizations, such as the British Council, Khan Academy, Storyweaver, Pratham Books, and more. We are in the process of adding to the list, and you can easily filter resources by partners, grades or standard, and the subject of instruction. We hope you find value in using these resources in your practice as teachers and educators. Finally, you can find the Firki app on the Play Store and can access these courses, resources, and webinars through your phone. So download our app and stay connected to teaching and learning on the go.
Thank you, Elizabeth, for sharing that. Hello, for those of you who just joined us, welcome to our webinar on technology for teachers, which is the need of the hour. We've just played a very small video introducing all of you to Firki. I hope that video helped you understand Firki, our website, and the resources available on it. If you have any questions around any of the features highlighted in the video, please write to us at contactfirki@teachforindia.org. The email address is in your chat box right now. All right, with that, I think we're ready to move into the webinar at hand today. Thank you for taking the time to join us in this discussion. In designing this and other webinars throughout the year, the Firki team is hoping that we can disseminate meaningful knowledge and skill that takes us closer to our goal of improving the quality of education in Indian classrooms. In this webinar, we will explore the Technology for Teachers series on the Firki platform, try out a few resources mentioned in the series, introduce a feature on the platform to collaboratively use the resources, and create a community of practice to support each other during the COVID-19 pandemic. And now I'll introduce the speaker for today. Deepali Dharmaraj has been working on large-scale teacher development projects across the country for over a decade in the areas of project design and implementation, focusing on academic quality. She is particularly passionate about teacher professional development, education policy, and multilingualism. She has a master's in sociology, a diploma in teaching English from the University of Cambridge, and a diploma in advertising and public relations. That brings us to the norms for the webinar today. Given the large audience that we are expecting today, please keep your video and mic off to reduce stress on the bandwidth. Unmute it only when our speaker is taking questions and comments. You can keep typing your questions in the chat box today during this webinar. Deepali will try and address as many of them as possible during the webinar, and I will be there to personally curate your questions and comments throughout the webinar and place them to Deepali during the open Q&A time at the end. Do remember that learning new things is often difficult, but challenge yourself and reflect on your thinking and experiences today. The best way to remember something is to write or discuss your learning with someone after the webinar. The webinar will be recorded and will be available on YouTube and the Firki website soon. This brings me to the end of my introduction for today. Thank you for your patience, and I hope you have an interesting evening. Over to you, Deepali, now. Deepali, you're on mute.
I'm on mute. Yes, of course, I'm on mute. Thank you very much, Rahul, for that introduction. I'm going to share my screen now. So can you see my presentation in edit mode?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am, we can.
Yes, we can.
Thank you. I'm just going to
Yes, we can, please.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Yes, we can.
Welcome, everyone, to this webinar. We have reached 300 participants, and I understand that there are still some waiting in the waiting room. We had over 1,300 registrations. Those of you who also put in your questions, I read as many as I could and have tried to answer or club them into themes, and I'll try and address them. Of course, I personally don't have all the answers, but the plan is for us to make a community of practice where we can reach out to each other for answers. I will, because of the the many people that are on this webinar, I will take questions at the end. Please write your questions down, and then you can post them in the chat when it's time for questions and answers. I just want to clarify at the very beginning that there are some areas I'm not going to be able to cover. So for example, in the questions that came through the registration link, there were questions about teaching geometry and maths and teaching engineering students. There were several questions about students who have special needs. So they're not, we're not going to be able to address everything, but I hope that this webinar will be the springboard for discussions Certainly, I hope some of you will get answers. If you are not able to get answers, like Rahul said, we'll curate the questions and then we'll answer them after this webinar is over. So with that said, I won't belabor the point any longer. I'll move on. Thank you very much for coming to this webinar. I hope you are all doing okay. Can you see my entire slide, or is this, is something?
Yes, Deepali.
Yes, ma'am. We can see
it's not visible.
See the entire slide, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Not entire.
Hello, guys. If you could please use the chat window to communicate with us when all of us share. We have 300 people on the call, so when all of us get off mute and share together, it's a little overwhelming. So if you can just use the chat window, that will be really helpful.
Yeah, and at the top right of your screen, you can change the settings to full screen. So if you put full screen, you'll be able to see the entire slide. So and if you have any questions, as Rahul said, please put them in the chat. So before we begin, because we are in unprecedented times, I just want to share this little quote by Emily Dickinson with you. I think the only thing that can keep us going is hope. So with that, let's get started. So as Rahul has already mentioned, but it bears repetition, in this webinar, we will explore technology for teachers, the series, which is on the Firki platform. I must also, of course, mention that it is on our British Council website. But for the purpose of this webinar, I'm going to refer to the resources as they are on the Firki platform. We're going to try out a few of the resources mentioned in the series. So I hope that you have the bandwidth. I mean, what better way to try out resources than to actually do something with them? So I hope that you're able to, access the links, etc. Again, if you have any issues with that, please put it in the chat. And of course, this webinar will be available after, even this session. We will introduce a feature on the platform to collaboratively use the resources. Working on that, the British Council and the Firki team. And we will create a community of practice to support each other during the COVID-19 pandemic. So I just want to say that this webinar is not going to be a single one-off thing where you attend a webinar and you get a few resources and you leave. The idea is that the learning from this webinar will be taken over to the Firki platform, and we will continue to work with each other and interact with each other there. So this is, setting up that. It's the first step to what we foresee to be a long-term engagement with many of you. So this is what the resource looks like, and it's on the Firki platform. So we asked you to ask the speaker some questions, and I've read through many of them, as many as I could. There were more than 1,300. And I've clubbed them into these three buckets that you can see on your screen. Skills, resources, and support. So in the areas of skills, I felt that in this time, teachers teaching in challenging times, there were a lot of technical skills that teachers need. There were skills related to managing learners. So how do we manage learners, online? How do we ensure that everybody's paying attention? How can we encourage, for example. There were several questions on assessment, assessing learners online. Evaluating options. So how do you choose and select the best option that you can use for your particular group of learners, or even or the facilities that you have at your disposal? And then methodology. So for example, learners, there was a question about somebody teaching very young students. So there was questions about how do I do that online? There were other questions about resources. Where can we find resources? How can we find resources that are relevant to us? There are several resources.
That it become louder and louder.
And there are safety and access issues. There were several points made about ensuring that there are safety components. In this For example, you will have noticed that you had to wait in the waiting room before the host was able to let you in. So that's an example of an additional safety feature that Zoom has introduced, you know, because of the issues that we face. And there were some questions about inclusion and special needs. One kind of question that I found was in terms of support. We are living in the midst of a pandemic. I mean, we should not minimize, I think, that at all. You know, so there are real, I mean, health fears, there are, you know, logistical challenges that we all face. You have to be conscious and aware, and you have to take care of your own mental health, because the stress can get to you. I mean, there's so many new things that we are learning during this time. As teachers, you are learning how to teach online. Perhaps you may never have done that before. And additional work. I mean, we all have to do our housework along with, and take care of our families, along with doing our job also and working from home. And we live in an uncertain future. So we don't know what teaching is going to look like, what education is going to look like. I mean, that's just one aspect of it. We don't know a lot about a lot of things at this point in time. So I picked out some of the ones that really stood out to me from the questions, your questions and comments, and I will just share them. I have only taken your first name, so I'm not identifying you completely, but I do want to acknowledge the people who asked these questions. I'll give you a minute to read through the comment or the question that's on your screen. So this is a question regarding, you know, having low resources or absolutely no resources. Students don't have access to smartphones or even, you know, internet. In some cases, of course, over here, it's particularly in limited internet data. Here's another one by Rajesh. And he says, COVID-19 is a wake-up call. Next year, I'm going to make the classroom more technology-driven. So I'm excited to know more about the series. So that's really something that is stood out to me as, you know, we're living, like I said, in unprecedented times. I mean, who would have thought, right? There were a number of questions about teachers and teaching. I was, you know, it was interesting to see how many participants commented on things like, do you think teachers are going to even exist, you know, in terms of will technology replace teachers? And those kind of questions. And how do teachers need to reskill themselves? And that is exactly the purpose of this webinar. And finally, there was a question that was particularly of interest to me because I work in the area of teacher education and development. And this was somebody who works, I think, as a mentor or a teacher educator or a head of a school. And it was a question of how we can help our peers and people that we mentor, teachers we mentor, who don't have expertise and experience in digital skills. A lot of teachers, as it's mentioned here, use WhatsApp and lack knowledge in browsing skills. So overall, this is kind of an overview of what I found in terms of when you were registering for this webinar and what your expectations of this webinar are. So I just want to ensure that we clarify and make sure we are all on the same page, the purpose of this webinar, what's going to be covered, what's not going to be covered, and of course the fact that I don't have all the answers. We have to crowdsource our answers and support each other. I do have experience, of course, and we have created this resource, but we're also looking at taking this beyond the duration of this webinar to the FIRKI platform. Okay. There's a poll now, so can I request the hosts to launch the poll?
Yes, we will launch the poll really shortly.
Thank you so much, Rahul.
You should see a poll on your screen. Please start voting. We have 150 people have responded so far. 200 people have responded.
Chintan, how confident are you about your
technique? 240 odd people have responded now. We can give it a few more seconds.
Yeah. I can see it on my screen also.
So okay. Fantastic.
Thank you. Okay. So I think with 253 responses out of a total number of 293 responses, the results, Rahul, will be shared at the end of the entire poll, right? You can log.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Okay.
So as you can see, many of you attending this webinar are quite confident with your skills. And I think you will find technology for teachers a resource that'll take you one step further. I think just by the virtue of the fact that you are attending this webinar, you have pretty good digital skills. Okay, Rahul, can we launch the next one, please?
Here you
go. So the question is, how are you using technology during the COVID-19 pandemic? Are you using it online? Do you teach online? Do you teach offline? You're not teaching at the moment because you're looking for options, and you're not teaching at the moment because you're on holiday. So the third one is because you're still kind of looking for ways and means to teach your learners during this time.
What if we are using two options out of it?
Unfortunately, you can only select one. But mention
okay.
In the chat.
Okay, great.
Interesting. So what is the other option that you're using?
First and second both.
We are using
online on the MWF and offline on TT. Yes.
Okay, fantastic.
Dipali ma'am, same with us.
Great.
Okay.
Supporting it with our WhatsApp.
Manage puts up all the same thing.
Fantastic.
Thank you. Hello.
So we've got 200.
Hello.
Yeah.
A quick reminder, guys, to place yourselves on mute and feel free to use the chat option to share your responses. Again, just a quick reminder, we have 300 people on this call, so it's going to be really hard if all of us, or even multiple of us, speak at the same time. Thank you.
Okay, I'll unmute myself. Right, so we had, is it visible on their screen, Rahul? Can they see it on the screen? Okay, so
yes.
This question, the responses were that most of you are using online tools. Okay, that's interesting to hear because the survey results, the registration results showed that many people were having to teach without access to the internet. So this is good to know that many of you here are, have access to the internet and have quite good digital skills. Okay, the next one, please. This is the final poll question. I'm sorry, Rahul and team. I have some messages on WhatsApp saying that my colleagues are blocked. I think it's because there are lots of people in the waiting room. So
yes.
Maybe you could just announce that it is being live streamed, right, on Facebook.
Yes, yes. So guys, in the chat window, a number of you have reached out saying your colleagues want to be able to access this webinar, but unfortunately Zoom has a 300-person limit. Ashwat right now has put down the link to the Facebook Live that we're also hosting. So even if you go to this link, copy paste this link from the chat box in your browser, you should be taken to Facebook where you will be able to engage with this webinar in person, except not on Zoom. So you can share this with your friends, your colleagues, etc. Dipali, I hope that's helpful.
Thank you. That's really great. Okay, so the poll is still going on. I can see the numbers are climbing rapidly. And the question is, where do you think you need the most support? So I'm just making sure that this presentation is pitched at the right level and that you go away feeling that you really have received support from us And if you know you haven't, you know what to do next. You know what the next steps are. Okay, so most of you have said 40. It's actually thank you. So most of you have said it's, and like I said, it's quite close. 45% of you want to develop your skills, and 40% want to find resources for your students. Okay, and just a few with nothing in particular. Thank you, Rahul. So I'll just close this now and move on to the next slide. Thanks, everyone. So what is technology for teachers? You saw in the introductory video that the British Council resources are on the FIRCI platform. And as you can see here, there's a little circle. You go to resources and you'll find our name here. You click on that and you'll find the resources in that folder or you know, in that, on that page. Technology for Teachers is a series of 18 guides that helps you become more digitally proficient. They focus on resources that you can use with your learners. So that is resources for teaching and for your own professional development. So there are a total of 18 two-sided sheets, and we provide you with links. We explain what they are, and we also give you some examples. In addition to this, a number of the guides have videos which are on YouTube. They're all linked in the guide itself via a QR code. And the QR code takes you directly to the YouTube video. You can either click on the QR code or you can use your phone, you know, if you want to watch it separately. And I'm going to show you how to do that in this webinar. So this is what it looks like. You may remember the video that we saw at the beginning, very similar. It was a different resource, but this is what it looks like. When you click on one, you know, it pulls up the resource. You can share it, you can bookmark it, or you can download it. You can also like it. So please use that feature. And these are free resources. They are free for you to download and use and share with your colleagues. So there are a total of 18, and I'm not going to go through them sequentially, but I have put them in buckets for the purpose of this webinar, just there in little, you know, chunks, so that you're able to see what your need is and you're able to then find the resource that is suitable for you and for your need. So for example, if you want to access resources, so you can take a screenshot of this page if you like, if you can take a picture of this page if you like. So accessing resources, we have four: finding professional development resources online, finding classroom teaching resources online, making the most of social networking groups, and joining online communities of practice. So there are four guides on how to access resources. Someone mentioned that they want to help the teachers that they work with find resources online. So there's a, you know, guide for that. Using resources, we have online collaborative tools, using online collaborative tools, using apps for professional development, using e-moderated courses for professional development, using podcasts, and using animation in the classroom. Of course, now you don't even need to use animation in the classroom. You can use animation while you're teaching online. So there's a guide and a resource for that with a lot of links to various resources. All of them are free. Where they have in-app purchases, we have mentioned them in the guide itself. Otherwise, all the resources that we have shared in Technology for Teachers are free resources for you. The next bucket or chunk is in sharing resources. So if you want to share with other colleagues and your peers, participating in online conferences, that is something that is very topical. Making the most of MOOCs. Do you know what MOOCs are, anybody? You can put it in the chat, please.
Yeah. Massive open online courses.
Thank you. Yes, perfect. So, you know, massive open online courses are free for most part. In most cases, the certificate is paid for. But there are courses that students and teachers and essentially anybody can access. Most of them are developed by, you know, large universities. And in addition, of course, the British Council, we have MOOCs for teachers and for students on the FutureLearn platform. And how can you access these and make the most of them, get the most learning? Because after all, these are self-paced and they are massive, you know, so you're interacting with hundreds and thousands of people. The next one is participating and hosting chats. We focus quite a bit on Twitter chats that you can also do with your learners. Of course, you have to be careful if you're working with your children and young learners. This might be more those of you who are in teacher education or working with adults, and giving webinar presentations, much like this one, and moderating online. Many of you said that you are using a variety of different resources and platforms to teach online now, and how can you effectively moderate your classes there? And finally, we have creating resources. So we've got recording audio for the classroom, for classroom teaching. Of course, you know, now you can contextualize it for the current environment. Using technology for the low resource classroom. So I have some additional support in this webinar for this particular context, because a number of the questions for the speaker in the registration form were about low resource classrooms. And then creating videos online. So again, this is support material for you to make your classrooms more interesting now, and designing effective presentations. Again, very topical and very relevant for us today. So I'm just going to take a quick look at the chat to see if there are any questions that have come up. Rahul, any questions that are related to this slide, or I need to
anything? Not yet. But I would like to use this time to remind people and encourage them to use the chat window to put in your questions. I'm right here to take them, and I'll curate them for Deepali to take them when she next pauses in the webinar. You can go ahead, Deepali.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so I'm now going to switch my screen to the Firki platform. I know you saw it already, but I'm just going to take you back there. So please give me a second. Okay, can you see my screen with the Firki platform?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay, so like I showed you on the one of the previous slides, you go to the resources page on the Firki platform. Remember that you need to sign in. So you can see me here. This is me. I'm signed in. I go to the to British Council. So I'm going to click on that. And you can see all our resources here on this page. So the one that I'm going to focus on for this webinar today is number 3. And I keep losing it, so please give me a second. So you can see here that we have a lot of other resources also on the platform, apart from technology for teachers. But for the purpose of this webinar, we're going to focus on just that one. So the one that I'm looking for is number 3. If you see it, please let me know. Okay, that's weird. I can't seem to see it. I'm just refreshing the page. And I hope that I'll be able to access it now. Here it is. Okay, so here it is. Here's Technology for Teachers 3 using online collaborative tools. So as you can see, I've liked the resource. I've also bookmarked it, and you can also download it. You can also share the resource on Facebook, Twitter, you can print it, you can email it, it's on Pinterest, Gmail. So there are lots of options for you. 181 more for you to share this resource. Like I said, please feel free. These are free resources for you. So I'm going to click on Technology for Teachers number 3, using online collaborative tools. Like I said, the resource tells you what it is. So it gives you a brief description about what it is. Then why it's important. So I think particularly, I selected this one particularly for this time that we are in where you are teaching online, and I'm sure you have to do a lot of online collaboration with your students. And then we give you a few examples. So in this particular guide, we featured Google Docs. So you can see here that Google Docs, we give you ideas on how you can use it for your professional development and how you can use it for your classroom teaching. You can see my screen, right, Rahul?
Yes, Deepali, I'm able to see your screen.
With the guide, I'm sharing the guide. Yeah, thank you. Okay, so here we are. I'm showing you Google Docs, how you can use it for your professional development and how you can use it for your classroom teaching. In addition, like I mentioned, several guides have QR codes or quick response codes. If you are accessing this on your laptop, you can click on the code directly. The link is embedded, or you can scan it using your phone. So I'm just going to click it very quickly, and I'm going to take you to the video that is supporting this particular resource.
You know, this young man just texted me right now. He took action with my program, which most people don't. He just made his first $1,000. He's 26.
Can you hear the audio, Rahul?
Yes. Yes, I can hear it.
In this video, we'll show you how you can collaborate with colleagues on different projects using an online tool called Google Docs. You can also use this tool with your learners for group assignments. In your internet browser, type google.com/docs/about, then select Go to Google Docs. Select the plus sign in the top left corner to start creating a document with a blank template. You can also select a pre-designed one from the template gallery. Scroll down until you get to the education section. Here, you'll find templates for writing essays, reports, class notes, and lesson plans. There are also templates for designing brochures and newsletters. Let's choose the lesson plan template. This is a collaborative document, which means that many people who are in different locations can work on it at the same time. For example, you want to collaborate with a colleague who lives in a different city to create this lesson plan. First, go to Share in the top right corner. Put your colleague's email address in this field. You can add as many people as you like. Your colleague will receive an email inviting him or her to collaborate with you on this document. You and your colleague can write simultaneously. The tool will show you who's added what. If you're not sure about something that your colleague has written, you can always ask them a question by adding a comment. To add a comment, right-click on the relevant section and select Comment. You can type a comment or question here. When your document is ready, you can share it with others in a number of ways. You can download your document as a Microsoft Word file or as a PDF document. If you plan to email your document or share it over social media, it's a good idea to download it as a PDF. You can also email the document as an attachment directly from Google Docs. We hope you enjoy collaborating online with Google Docs.
Okay, I'm going to go back to my presentation now. sorry, please give me a second. Okay, so I'm going back now to the Firki platform. So you have to become quite familiar with the platform, because every time you go back, you have to do the same steps all over again. So here we are, if you can remember, it's in resources. And then I go to the British Council. And then I look for, can you remember which one we were looking at? Which technology for teachers? And can you see it on my screen?
Yeah, collaborative planning.
Okay, fantastic. I'm looking for it on my screen. It keeps disappearing. There it is. Yeah, so I showed you how you can click on the QR code. It takes you to the video. Some have videos, not all of them. And this one showed you how to use Google Docs. Then we talk about Google Sheets, again, for your professional development and for use in classroom teaching. And then we feature an external resource. This one is called Padlet. Please note that Padlet is partially free. There are some paid for additional features. So wherever, like I mentioned, wherever this is true of the resources that we have shared, we mention it in a note so that you're aware of the cost implications of any resource that you use. So the Padlet is a collaborative tool, again, that helps you post images and text and share and, comment. And it's a very interactive and creative platform. Finally, the British Council Technology for Teachers series is linked to the British Council CPD, or Continuing Professional Development for Teachers. This is the tool that we use to describe the professional practices that teachers need and can develop. And this one focuses, of course, on integrating ICT, which is developing effective strategies for locating appropriate content. So this is the British Council resource on the platform. I'm going to go back now to my PowerPoint presentation. So I showed you now how it looks and how you can access it on the platform. Now we're going to try it out, okay? I'm going to copy and paste this link into your, into the chat. So please hang on a second. I have stopped sharing screen. So I'm going to just give you access to this particular one. This is Padlet. So I'd like you, if possible, we're just trying this out. Where is the chat? Okay, so I'm posting a link. Please click on this link and it'll take you to an external site, or it'll take you to Padlet. So can you try that, please? Let's see how many people can access the Padlet feature.
Just a heads up, guys. You will not be able to click it. You'll have to copy paste it into your browser.
Oh, sorry. Thanks, Rahul.
Zoom doesn't allow that feature anymore. I mean, they have restricted features based on like Zoom bombing, etc. So you'll have to copy paste it and place it into your browser, that particular link.
And I don't think the people who are watching on Facebook will be able to access it, or can you put it in the comments there?
No, we will put it there as well.
Thank you. So I'm going to share my screen now. Taking you to that Padlet. So this is the Padlet feature. This is where you should be now. You should have access to this. You can see some of my colleagues just today. We created this Padlet board. So you should be able to access this. And I would like to see you add content during this webinar. So this is called Technology for Teachers webinar. And I want you to describe yourself in a word and a picture, using one word and a picture. Please don't use fantastic, fantastic, Gomati. I can see that you are there. Fantastic, lovely. So please don't use images of children. That's you.
Okay.
confused. If you want, you can save this link, and I'll keep this dashboard open. I'm just going to refresh it because I think many people are posting and we're not able to see the new posts. So it's just going to take some time. Fantastic. Imagination. Kalpana, lovely to see you here. So I'm going to keep this open. Please feel free to add after this webinar. You don't have to. So this is one of the features of Padlet. I'll just quickly. You can create a dashboard. You can design it on privacy settings. So you can set it in such a way that only certain people have access, or you can open it to the public. This particular webinar, I kept it open, but I will restrict access after some time. And you can set it so that, if people want to post, they can. So you can set it, create the settings in such a way that people can either ask for permission, or you can allow free posting like I have now. Great way for, we use this tool a lot for reflections for you as a teacher, if you have any homework or assignment. Again, Padlet is free, but there are some paid services. So this is an example of using Padlet. Fantastic. Thank you, everyone. Really well done. It's very interesting to see so many. We'll come back to this at the end of the webinar also. So I'm going to go back to my presentation now. And I'll share the next link with you. Again, please do the same thing. I'm going to copy it and paste it in the chat. And then you have to copy it and access the sheet, and I'll share my screen with you.
It's been placed in the chat window, guys. Some of us, I've noticed some of us said you can click on it. If you can click on it, that's great. If you cannot, please copy it and paste it in your browser.
Okay, Rahul, can you see the Excel sheet on my screen? Fantastic. Okay, so there are just two things that you need to add here: your name, and how many years have you been teaching? That's it. I can see Priyanka's put her name in. You don't have to use your full name, of course, if you want anonymity, but it's up to you. Like I said, I will close this after some time. I've kept it open for now. So you should be able to access this. Fantastic. Thank you, Priyanka. Well done. Fastest finger first. Rahul, how are we doing for time?
We're at 6:10. You've asked me to give you a heads up at 6:20. So we've got 10 more minutes before that.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, well done, Pranoti Vasumana. So we're looking at columns A and B, everybody. Columns A and B.
Guys, some of you are putting it on the chat window. We request you to use the link. I'm going to place the link to this to the sheet once more. If you can use the sheet, I know even I'm getting the same message that due to heavy traffic, it's not every one of us can be on the same sheet together. But if you can, then request you to please do. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. I understand. And I'm not going to take, I don't want to take your bandwidth also. I can see there are 28 people here. 33. So you get the point. I mean, this is something that people can do either together or you can just share the sheet and people can add, your students can add information. Again, of course, I'm sure you are, as this group who has attended this webinar, is fairly confident with using digital skills. I'm sure you will be able to, access the additional features that Excel has. And then finally, there's just one last one. So I'm going to share my screen again, and I'm going to put this link. in the chat. Again, please access it as you feel. Sorry. Okay, please copy that and access it. And this one, this is the question. What do you enjoy most about using technology? Well done. Priyanka, fantastic. You are very, very quick. Well done. Okay, so I'm just going to keep this open. You can switch between the Excel sheet. Lots of opportunities to teach, yes. So you can switch between the sheet, between Padlet and between Excel, and I'll go back to the webinar because I'm conscious of time and I don't want to overstep the time limit here. Okay. So these are the three resources, like I said, in sheet number three that have been mentioned. And I've showed you how, and of course, I'm sure this is not the first time that you've used them, but it just gives you an idea of how it can be used collaboratively, both live as well as, as a shared document with people coming in and leaving whenever they are free. So now I'm moving on to the next part of the webinar, where we are introducing the new feature that we are going to implement after this webinar is over. So we're back here to our lovely Filki platform, and I'm on this page called Webinars. When you go to the Webinars page, the first webinar that will pop up is this one, today's British Council 6 Technology for Teachers Need of the Hour. We've added a placeholder video here, and this video, the video of this, webinar will be uploaded at a later point in time. The team will let you know. Now, we are going to introduce a new feature here called discussions. So we would like you to, first of all, sign up, register to the Filki platform, access our resources. I hope that you've attended this webinar, share this webinar with your colleagues and friends. And then we're going to start a discussion forum here Filki team and I will work on over the next few months. So let's see how it goes. We want to be able to have an ongoing discussion with you on this topic. So the topic is technology for teachers. You know that there are 18 guides. If you have any doubts or questions about how to use the guides, this is the place for you to post them. If you have any other kind of ideas to share, or if you want create your own resources, you've created some resources and you want to share them with the group that has attended this webinar, please do so also. There will also be additional resources, the resources that are both on the platform and any additional ones that we share with the team. And of course, there's an overview of the webinar. So please do go here. I'm looking forward to reading your comments and interacting with you and getting to know you a little bit better. So that's the new feature, that's the community of practice, the third and fourth points in our learning objectives of this webinar. I'm going back to my presentation. Rahul, it's all working smoothly, right? The screen switching, you can see.
Yes.
Okay, so the last thing that I want to just focus on, a couple of things are, before we get to the questions, is what do you consider when you are selecting digital resources for your learners? The first one, of course,
is the definition.
Hold on 1 second, Deepali. Guys, I would like to request you to kindly place yourselves on mute. This is just to prevent any cross conversations happening here. Thank you.
Okay, so this is access. A lot of you mentioned that, some of you, I won't say a lot, sorry. Many of you mentioned that you are working with special needs children. Also, there is a, working with students in low resource areas, where kids don't have access to their own phone, let alone a laptop or even internet access. So think about what is the access that your learners have when you're thinking about using this particular resource. Safety issues are very important to consider. Is it open for bombing, for example? Any weirdos are able to attend your webinars? Make sure that you're able to, have some sort of gatekeeping, and the feature that you select has that. What are the features of it? So you saw Padlet, for example, allows you to do certain things. It doesn't allow you to do some. There are cost implications in many of the resources. So what are the features that you have to select? What is the relevance to your learners? So for example, there are some resources that we may share or that you have found that are not really relevant to the learners that you work with. So that's one of the criteria. And finally, integration. What we have learned in the British Council in running our online courses is that you must have multiple channels for engaging with your audience. So for example, when we run the Becoming a Better Teacher short course on FutureLearn, we also have the platform. We also have WhatsApp groups for teachers on our projects. We also have additional webinars. We also have a Facebook and Twitter posts that are, when the course is running, we coincide the content to map to the course that is running. So if there's perhaps one thing that you can take away from this, it is don't depend on just one resource to access your learners and to support your learners during this time. Look for multiple ways that you can support them. So these are this is kind of the overview of this. I just added one additional thing, considering the few questions that I got in terms of students with low resource context. And for this, one of my colleagues, Anne, put together a really nice list of these ideas, activities, and I'm just going to share them with you with many thanks to her. These are not all mine. So these are some activities. I'll just pull them all up on the screen together, and you're free to take a picture of the screen and use these with your learners. I think we don't have time to go through all of them now, and I'd rather spend some time answering, discussing and focusing on questions.
I'm just going to put it out there. For any questions you'd like to ask, please put them in the chat box. I'm making a note of that. We will open up shortly for questions.
Thank you, Ryan. Thank you.
Excuse me. Can we get the handout, please?
Yes. Like as I mentioned in the chat box, all the resources used in this webinar, including the presentation and the links to absolutely everything, will be shared soon. It will be available on the Fitki platform as well as sent in email. Thank you.
Any certificates for it?
Not at this point. We would request you to kindly engage with us on the chat box. This is just so we can make sure we're ending on time. Thank you. Okay.
So here are some ideas and tasks that you can assign your students as home tasks during this COVID-19 period, and then they can report back on how they've done. So just a disclaimer, I started out as an English teacher, so a lot of these activities may be related largely to English, but of course there is a little maths problem there thrown in for good measure, and I'm sure that there are teachers here in this webinar who teach other subjects also. So please do add your ideas on our discussion forum. I hope there will be a surge in numbers in terms of registration on the Firki platform so that we can start kind of collaborating and working together. Okay, before we go to questions, because I think maybe that might take a little bit of time. Rahul, we're at 6:20, so we're okay to kind of wrap up now. Thank you.
Yes, we can wrap up now. We can take a few more minutes.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. That's what I need. So we have, in addition to the content that I have shared with you in this webinar, We also have a number of free resources for you as teachers that I just want to take you through very quickly. The links are embedded in this presentation. So when you get the presentation, you can click on the link and you can access the resource. The Teaching English website has hundreds of high quality resources with a special section at this moment for professional development opportunities to support teachers and teacher educators during the COVID-19 crisis. Teaching English Radio is a series of 24 15-minute audio programs that you can listen to. These are available on our website, on our British Council website. Education in Focus South Asia is a podcast series which aims to promote a better understanding of relevant research, key challenges and innovations related to improving teaching and learning. Teach English in India, we have a community of practice on Facebook and Twitter. So please follow us on Facebook, Teach English in India, and on Twitter, at Teach ENG Ing India. That's who we are, so please follow us. And I already mentioned our short courses on FutureLearn. We have courses both for students as well as teachers. And because I know that you are also teachers, we have British Council support for students. Again, these are all free resources. We have the Learn English Kids website, Learn English Teen website, Learn English, which is for adult learners to improve your English skills. We have short courses on FutureLearn for students. We have Learn English Grammar, which is a practice app for grammar to develop your accuracy. We have Sounds Right, which is an interactive phonemic chart to help improve pronunciation. And we have Learn English podcasts, which are audios for learners. And all these are available as our apps. So I can see Vanita's raised her hand. Hi, Vanita. Nice to see you here. So I'm done, Rahul, with my presentation, and I'm happy to take questions.
Yes, I'm just going to make a note of a couple that have just come in. Give me 30 seconds. Okay, so we've got a few questions coming in. Let me start from a few that have come in a little earlier. So I have this question. Yeah. So I've got this question from Rivati and a number of other individuals as well. Does the British Council offer resources in other regional languages? Rivati was specifically asking about Tamil, but are there any online resources across regional language? I think would make sense to us.
No, we don't have any. We focus on English teaching.
Thank you very much. Okay, another one is, if you write me as a question, do you have tutorials for Jamboard, Mindem Up, etc.? Or can you at least tell us a few of the other softwares that there are resources for?
So, at this point in time, nothing comes to mind. But if you look at the resources, the Technology for Teachers series, I'm sure you'll find resources there. We don't have any specific webinars on any specific such. Reskilling of teachers about the use of technology. I can see one question there. Can I take that? I've lost you, Rahul. I can't hear you. Rahul, I can't hear you. I can't hear you, Rahul. Should I go ahead with some questions?
Sorry. Can I have a question, please?
Yes, please. Go ahead.
Which platform is the best for teaching English online for the university students? If you don't mind.
University students, if you check the Teaching English website that I mentioned and which will be accessible through the presentation, in a link, you will find some resources for higher education and for university students. But I say that for a large part, those are for teachers from K to 12. But I'm happy for you to, I mean, if you have access to the Firki platform. Are you in India? I'm not sure if you're in India.
Not really. I'm just from Iraq, but I'm teaching university students and I try to do my best for them, specifically for the interactive videos, if you like.
Yes, yes.
Hello.
The discussion, and I can also,
Hello, madam.
I can ask. Yes, please.
Am I audible now?
Yes, I can hear you now, Rahul.
Okay, so I'm just going to put a couple of questions to you. You can definitely take the one about reskilling for technology. We'll start with that and then I'll take pose a couple more.
Yeah, yes, okay. So reskilling for technology, yes, we have one of the short courses on FutureLearn. It's not ours, it's not the British Council one. It's on teaching online. But if you go to FutureLearn, you will be able to access that course. Like I said, FutureLearn courses are free, as with many MOOCs, and it's the certificate that you need to pay for. But you can access that on the FutureLearn platform.
Hello? Hello?
Thank you very much. Guys, we request you to please place yourselves on mute. I'm going to be posting questions to Deepali here. This another one that I've had is, can you list some safety measures while teaching or working online with children? Just a few generic safety measures that you think would hold teachers in good stead when they're working with technology and children together.
Yes. I think the first thing is, before you start working with children online, you need to ensure that they know and they are alert to what dangers are lurking out there, you know, what they need to be aware of. So I think that's the first thing. You need to give them some tips and tricks on how they need to stay safe. So for example, something like opening links that are from trusted sources, you know, not opening any and every link that comes to them. Ensuring that there is adult supervision when they are accessing a resource. Ensuring that you have checked the resource beforehand before sharing with the students. Ensuring that you, if you're doing your classes online, that you have a closed group.
Hello?
So for example, Zoom has this feature where you can admit adults and people cannot just enter, using the link. So there are, those are some of the things that come to mind with respect to teaching children online. I would also say, don't use camera, because as far as possible, restrict the use of camera when you're teaching students, very young learners.
Great. We have a ton of questions actually that are coming in on the specific concept of technology in assessment. Mm-hmm. People just have generic questions from, do you recommend it, number one? Number two, what are some ways we can incorporate technology into designing and conducting assessments for our students?
Yes, so I'd love to answer that. I think technology is great in terms of assessment. I saw a question even in the registration on using MS Forms. So MS Forms has, of course, as you know, two features. You can use it as a survey, but you can also design a quiz using MS Forms. So that's something that is very user-friendly and easy to use. There's also Google Forms, which has many additional features. You can also upload pictures and you can ask them questions about that. So that's, I think what is important to know also is, what are you trying to assess? So it depends on the skill that you're trying to assess. Based on that, you can use the assessment tool. Another tool that we use, which is now actually, I think, a paid resource, is there's Quizlet, and there's another one, I can't remember the name now. Kahoot. Kahoot is an online quiz, which is a multiple choice kind of quiz, aspect. So these are all useful for assessment where there is one correct answer. But I think also we need to develop our students' skills for different kinds of assessment. So Padlet, for example, asking them to write some text, and a picture, And having that as, and setting that in as an assessment is also something that you can do. So you can use it as both, you know, and multiple choice where there's one specific answer, or you can have a more kind of qualitative kind of an assessment for students.
Thank you very much. A couple more questions have come up. So the first one is from Vanita. How do we ensure sustainability of using technology or its integration into the teaching learning process post COVID-19? As for most teachers, it's a forced practice with respect to the current situation.
That's a very big question, Vanita. Thank you for it. So, I mean, I have an opinion, and I think the opinion is that I don't think teaching is going to be the same after the COVID-19. I think our skills will develop phenomenally. That's one thing. I think the second thing is teachers will find themselves learning from their learners, because, a lot of our learners are more proficient than us in, technology and using digital resources. So that's definitely one thing. In terms of sustainability, I think as teachers and, you know, anyone in teacher education even, should think of ways of integrating technology as a core part of any program, rather than as something that is done at the periphery. So I hope that answers the question.
Thank you very much. We've got a few very specific niche questions, but I'm going to bucket them and then you can decide if you want to take them split apart or together. The questions revolve around various permutations and combinations of how do I use technology to teach either students in very young grades, middle school, high school. There are three separate sets of questions, or very niche my subject area, such as math or English or something very specific. So those sorts of questions have come up a bit.
Okay, but you'll share. You're going to share the questions with me after the webinar, right? And we'll.
Yes. We made a list, and we can share that with you. But the one specific. Okay, so a couple of specific ones, for example, that have come up here is: what resource or platform is most suitable to teach analytical subjects such as math? And then there are other such questions, but more geared towards English. Others are geared towards higher secondary classrooms and primary. So they're very niche, but technology towards these specific areas.
Yeah, I saw a very good one. Some Revati has said, but access in all caps. And I think, that is it, right? I mean, that is the elephant in the room. That's why I had that poll at the beginning to find out who is attending this webinar and what kind of access your students have to technology. Because what I saw from the registration was several teachers were saying, our students don't even have access to technology, what can we do? So that's why I had that slide on the different activities. But I think definitely I saw a video that a colleague of mine shared with me on a reporter who had gone into a Delhi, an area where access is quite limited, access to technology, etc. And the students had received the text as a PDF on their phone, the screen was cracked, and the students were trying to learn from that. I think we have to be, that's one of the criteria when selecting either technology or not using technology. So what are the other ways that you can get in touch with your learners? Can you send them an SMS? Can you, get in touch with them a different way? I can't think of anything just now, but I think the situation that we're living in at the moment in COVID-19 is, what are the avenues that we have available? What are the avenues that our students have available, and how best can we meet that need? Of course, how can you prepare for a situation like this, right? So I think technology for teachers is not just for this pandemic. It's much broader, it's beyond, and it's before. I mean, we created the content. So certainly we can't answer all the questions related to the issues that we face at this current moment.
Thank you very much. Another question that's come up is one that has come up a couple of times. How can we make remote learning inclusive? There were a couple of versions of this, one including all children, getting that, how do we use technology to ensure that all students that we can't be in person with remotely are learning.
Fantastic. So that's a topic of a completely different webinar. And we are having a webinar, the British Council, on the 30th of April on online teaching essentials. And there's another one, I think it's also on the 30th of April. If you follow us on Facebook and Twitter, you'll know exactly when it is, on remote teaching. So it is focused on just that topic. So please, can you attend that? And you'll get many ideas and tips.
Hello.
Request you to please place yourselves on mute. Yes. Okay. Yeah, Deepali, can you hear me?
I was just saying. Nadeem said thank you for taking that, so I said thank you to him. It's nice to see him here. It's nice to see so many familiar names and faces.
Okay, so we've got a question from Venkatesh, who's been asking us this for a little while. Can you please talk about how classroom management plays a role in teaching online?
Yes, I can. So, I mean, if you look at the example of this webinar, I think one of the things is... So I think as you would do in... The first is to lay ground rules.
Hello.
Anji.
Please place yourselves on mute. Yes, Deepali.
Yeah, so I think the first thing when you are teaching online, the first thing like you did, Rahul, in this webinar today, you know, you laid ground rules. And we do that in any, training or teaching. I've been a teacher.
Hello.
Now, so I'm looking at it from that perspective. So on the first day, you know, you would lay.
Hello.
You'd have a training room contract or you'd have a classroom.
Yeah, window, yeah.
And you have some.
Yeah, likha hua hai.
So you'd have some basic rules and sort of instructions for your students. So that's the first thing. The second thing is, of course, in a webinar of this size where we currently have 272 participants, it's not possible to hear from everybody. So look at whatever features are available to you in whatever platform you are using. If it's on Zoom, you can use the chat feature like you are all using here. If it's a smaller class, make sure that you ask every single learner to contribute and to say something. I saw a Facebook Live the other day. One of our colleagues in the British Council did that. And they said a good idea is to turn your camera off. So, and mute yourself as a teacher when you set a task for the students to do. Because if they see you there, sometimes they might hesitate to speak. But if they, if you're in the background and if you're not so visible, then they have more chances of interacting with each other. So those are some things that I can think of off the top of my head. I'm sure that there will be more that I can share with you on how you can ensure that all your learners are engaged in the class, in an online class.
Thank you very much. Keeping the same line of thought, through online teaching, how can we support students who remain demotivated often in class?
I think it's a matter of knowing your students, knowing what motivates them and what, keeps them engaged. Maybe the topic is not interesting enough. Maybe it's too challenging. Maybe it's too simple. There are many reasons why students are not motivated. Maybe they're just not getting enough sleep. I mean, I think going back to what I said at the beginning of the webinar, we're living in the midst of a pandemic. So, we have to cut ourselves some slack and we have to be kind to ourselves and to our students. They might be worried. There may be a family member who's unwell. So motivation is something that, there's so many factors that affect motivation. But I would say periodically ask your learners, take feedback from your learners, find out how they are enjoying it, find out what they would like to do. Use MS Forms, create a quick survey for them. They'll find it fun to answer. And get their feedback, make it anonymous so that they're able to share their feedback with you without hesitating and without being fearful about giving you feedback. So that's what I would suggest as a teacher and teacher trainer.
Thank you. We've got a question.
I agree completely with Nageshri. We should make students passionate so that they get interested. I couldn't agree more.
Lakshmi asked us this question a couple of times. She's told us that she's a new teacher. She says, is there something that she should specifically keep in mind, given that she's new to the profession of teaching, and she's at the same time trying to navigate technology simultaneously?
I think you're at an advantage because many teachers are at a place where they have been teaching a certain way for many years, and now suddenly they have to adapt and relearn many things. So I think you're at an advantage. What I would say is teaching online is, in my experience, not that different from teaching face-to-face. I recall one of the MOOCs that I was a lead educator on. And essentially what I found that teachers, the course participants, in this case was teachers, in your case will be students. But what they enjoyed most was the interaction. They enjoyed having somebody, read their comments, like their comments, interact, ask them questions, promote discussion, validate their comments. Many people would, talk about the challenges that they are facing as teachers. So it's not about saying, you shouldn't feel this way and you shouldn't have these, you're minimizing the challenges, but it's about acknowledging and respecting them. So I don't think online teaching is that different. Yes, there are technical aspects to it that, cause differences. There are some things that you can do online that you can't do in the classroom and vice versa. But essentially the skills and the approach that the teacher needs to use is, that of ensuring, empathy, authenticity, ensuring equal participation, ensuring inclusion, those principles, they never fail.
Thank you very much. We've got a couple of questions that are coming in. One, or a few questions around the same theme on teaching art remotely. Any ideas on how you can leverage technology to teach art, drawing? Those are the themes that people are asking.
I wish I could. I'm really a lousy artist. I'm very sorry. My forte is English teaching.
Okay, thank you. So then I'm going to ask you the English teaching question specifically on that. How can you support students who are extremely young through technology?
Yes, so I think I addressed some of that through the activities. I think it is unreasonable, to put it mildly, to expect students to sit in front of the computer, for the duration of a school day. It's not possible. It's not even good for them, so much screen time isn't good. So I would suggest you set tasks for them that they can do and then report back. So it's about rethinking the way you would do something in a classroom and setting it so that students can go off, their parents can help them complete the task, and then they report back on that, at a particular time. So you can meet them in the morning, set the tasks for them to do. They go back, they do the tasks, and then they meet you again. Those are some ideas that I can think of. But obviously, I don't think something like this, a young learner cannot sit through a webinar like this for a 2-hour period. They'll just go, they won't be able to sit.
Okay, I've got a couple more questions. So Akifa, and I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly, apologies if I'm not. Akifa says online teaching and learning could be the future. How relevant or how important is it for teachers to be specifically trained for that? And can it revolves closely to your reskilling question earlier. How much reskilling is required? How much reskilling is enough reskilling?
So I think in an ideal world, it would be very good to have teachers who were skilled in a particular area. But I think if you're looking at it in the current scenario where we are at the moment in the pandemic, we don't have a choice. We just have to do it, right? So it's a little bit about upskilling and reskilling and doing it, and upskilling and doing it. So it's these two things that are going hand in hand.
Thank you. A few more questions. So Venkatesh asks, before that, just want to give you a heads up, everybody, that even though Deepali may not have had the answers to the art questions, a number of our users, a number of our participants today have had some suggestions. So would recommend that you scroll through the chat window whenever you get a chance. And if your question was about art, definitely read up on some of the suggestions made by some of our other participants here. And thank you very much for making this a productive space in the chat.
Yes, so lovely, Ashwa. Thank you for sharing that. Yes.
Thank you very much, Ashwa.
Complete the platform.
Another question has come up is from Venkatesh. Can you express your opinion, Dipali, on time management during online classes, given that there are critical constraints with regard to that?
So time management with reference to an online like class like this, or?
I'm assuming, and correct me if I'm wrong, Venkatesh, the perception is that technology, classes that have technology take longer because you have to problem solve for technology, you have to set up, you have to support students, etc. How do you solve for those constraints given that you may have a limited time frame in a class, in a lesson?
So my kind of, and again, please, I'm not an expert in that, but I would say definitely from the work that I have done and the online training that I have done, I think preparing beforehand is very important. Know what you have to do. So prepare beforehand, but also have a backup plan. So if something you think you think it's not going to work, then have a backup plan. More than anything, you know, the difference between technology and face-to-face teaching is the fact that technology is more unpredictable than face-to-face teaching. And there are things that can come up that you would never have been able to foresee. So like, for example, today we didn't foresee that we'd only be able to have 300 participants when 1300 registered. But I think we've solved that, right, through Facebook. I don't know how that's going. I can't see. So
I've been posting some questions here from Facebook as well. So I'm hoping to be able to answer that as well. All right. So let's come to a couple more as well. Sunanda, I'm going to put your question now, but I've not understood it completely. If you'd like to add any context, please feel free to do so in the chat window. Sunanda asks, what are we looking at when we say communicative competence? How much is fluency? What are the parameters? Again, I'm just going to put it out there. That's another not fully understanding your question. Dipali, if you did, you can take that. If not, we can just want to put it out there so that Sunanda can continue to add more context in the chat window. Even apart from that, I wanted to ask a question that I got through from Narayana right now. Is blended learning an ideal way of teaching in this current scenario?
Okay, so I'll take that communicative one. So I think it depends on what it is that your students have to communicate. So is it English for academic purposes? Is it, you know, for further education? Is it for employability? Are your students teachers and they need to communicate with their learners? They need to give classroom instructions. You know, what is it? It's, I think the purpose for which you are teaching English, specifically if it is English as a second or third language, the reason or the context is very important. So, you know the context, and according to that, there are plenty of resources out there. I mentioned our Teaching English website. They literally have hundreds of resources there to help in many different areas of communicative skill development. The other question was about online, is it the best? I think on blended learning, So I think in my opinion, you know, we don't know what is the best. Again, it depends on your learners. There was a question there from Revati about access. So if your students don't have access, where is the possibility for online learning, right? You have to depend on face-to-face, or you have to be creative and depend on different ways of teaching. So I think it is very important for you to know there's no such, I mean, I don't think there's any blanket thing of best and worst. I think it is depends on your context. And I know, this might sound like a cop-out, but that's the truth. So you have to know your context, and it depends on the context that you are in, you know, for you to be able to know which is the best option for your students. I think I just want to end by saying right now we don't have a choice.
That makes sense. Just a quick heads up before I push on to the next question is, guys, I'm putting a link to the feedback form in the chat box. it really helps us if you take a few minutes after the webinar to answer this form and to give us feedback on the webinar today. It helps us identify what we're doing well and what we can do better for our future webinar. So really appreciate it if you could do that sometime after the webinar is done. With that, I'm going to ask one more question that came up a little earlier.
Rahul, can I interrupt? I just need 5 minutes before we end, because I want, like I said, I want to go back to Padlet and the shared resources to see how.
So then I'm going to ask you one last question. I'm going to make this the last question and then share access to email IDs as well as Twitter account feed so that the participants can pose more questions in the future. But the question that I'm going to take right now is on differentiated instruction. How can we leverage technology to support students in a differentiated manner? Is a question that came up.
Differentiated instruction.
To support different learners at different levels of readiness.
So that's online or in the classroom?
Online. How can you use technology to support students who are different levels of readiness in the same class or same group of students?
Okay, so I would suggest if you're able to. I mean, this is a very it's a very advanced question and that we need, that bears further discussion. I'm going to try and answer it in like 2 minutes.
Oh, but boy, you're back.
You have students who are who know what their levels are. Zoom, for example, and other resources. You've muted me. Okay, I think I'm unmuted. First of all, you know what different levels your students are. You know the differentiation, I'm assuming that. Zoom, for example, has features like breakout rooms. What you can do is when you're setting up tasks, you can design tasks so that you set the learners into different breakout rooms depending on the levels that they are at and depending on the skills that you want developed or that they need developed. So that's one example of differentiation online.
Thank you very much. I'm going to pause for the questions here. And guys, please hold on. At the end of this webinar, I will share where you can reach out to us, share a few email IDs that you can reach out to for further questions you might have. I'm going to hand it over to Deepali once more.
So I've lost Rahul. Yeah, Rahul? Yes? Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you now.
Yeah,
yes?
Sorry. I'm throwing it over to you. For the last 5 minutes, I'm going to pause the questions now and share email IDs at the very end once more.
Okay, thank you. Please, everybody, please answer the feedback form. We'd love your feedback. Okay, so I'm just going to take you now to the, let's see how we're doing. Okay, so here we are. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. So there are lots of responses here. To refresh it. Lots of responses, fantastic. Thank you so much. Oh, nice, okay. Thank you very much. I've also enabled the feature where you can comment on each other's. So please do comment and like each other's Padlets also, the posts also. I'm going to check how we're doing on our Google Sheet. Okay, nice. We've got a lot of responses here. Very nice. You've tried. There are lots of people using different features and are fantastic. So we've got quite a few responses. Thank you very much. That's great to see. So I'll keep this open for a few days and you all can keep adding to it, particularly the Padlet. I find that particularly enjoyable. Okay, Rahul, over to you.
All right. With that, I'm going to thank Deepali for being incredibly generous with her time and expertise today. Deepali, if you could also take a minute maybe to share your thoughts on how this webinar went, on how the participants engaged, etc.
Yeah, fantastic. I will. Can you see my screen? I just want to double check.
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to try and stop sharing. How do I do that?
At the top of your screen, you should get a view option.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, so I've stopped sharing. It was fantastic. Like I said, it's so great to see familiar faces and names. I can see Shyam and of course Nadi, many of you, Vanita. So thank you very much. Lovely to see you all. Your team, Rahul, is fantastic. I know you all for a couple of years. We've worked together as with the British Council, Ashwath, Prerna, who's working at the back end. And I really look forward to us collaborating on the discussion forum and working with everybody here in the meeting and on Facebook to take this discussion further. It's certainly not the end. I know that there were I don't have all the information. I don't know everything. But, I think we need to learn as a community and develop and grow as a community. And most importantly, support each other during this difficult time.
Thank you very much. Couldn't agree anymore and was a pleasure having you. With that, we've come to the end of our webinar today. Our next webinar is scheduled to take place on April 29th with Teach a Class on Discovering Innovative 21st Century Tools for the Indian Teacher. So do look for Firki emails in your inbox for information on this upcoming webinar. Before you leave, participants, please take a minute to give us feedback on your learning experience on our webinar today. It helps us grow and improve our offerings for you. Ashwath will place the link in the chat box. To reach out to Deepali after the webinar, you can write to teachenglish.india@britishcouncil.org. You can also follow Teach India, all of that will be put into the chat box. On Twitter and Teach English in India on Facebook for more updates. And I'm hoping that we can connect with more educators on FIRKI and on British Council soon. With that, we've come to the end of today's webinar. Thank you so much for being a part. We hope it was a great learning experience for you. It was certainly a wonderful experience for us putting this together. Have a great evening. Thank you.